So let's start this topic, which is called Mutex Lock. So in the hardware solutions that is having different instructions, and those instructions are the atomic instructions. So those are giving us the solution, but those are more complicated. And those are not actually the software solution. The second thing is to solve this particular issue, the complication issue, the operating system designer have come up with another solution to the critical section problem, which is called Mutex Lock. And in this particular Mutex Lock for the critical section solution, it has two functions. One is the acquire function and another is the release function. So the acquire function is used to acquire the critical section permission and release. So whatever the permission has been given, it has to release it. So these two functions are there. And again, these two functions are the atomic function, means all the instructions in these functions will execute at once without any preemption or without any context switching. So this particular lock comes into the category of Boolean. Boolean lock means it has only two values, 0 or 1. So if we are acquiring the lock, it means that when a process is calling the acquire function, the whatever the Boolean value is becoming 0. And whenever we are releasing the lock, the value will become 1. So 1 indicate that the critical section is free. 0 indicate that the critical section is busy, means some other process has already occupied it. We'll call to acquire and release must be atomic. That is the thing, means the acquire function and the release function should be atomic, usually implemented by a hardware atomic instruction. But these solution require busy waiting. So here we have the concept of busy waiting. I'll let you know what you mean by busy waiting. This lock therefore called spin lock. So when we use any of the lock, so when we want to use the lock, we use the acquire function. Acquire function will give us the lock. And once we get the lock, other process could not get its critical section. And in that way, the process which want to go into the critical section need to wait. And this wait is for a certain period of time, or it will be in a loop, that is called busy wait. Okay, now we have two functions, as we know, acquire and release. Acquire, in this we have a loop, while loop. Available means if this particular available function is false, it means that it is giving you the value true, right? Means not false means it will become true. So if it will become true, we have to go to the busy wait. It means that if available will be false, no other process will be allowed. Otherwise, if the available is true, then we'll make available as false and we can enter into the critical section. Now release function, what it will do is, it is just make available as true. That will be done by the release function. So as we all know that, to access the critical section, we have two things. One is the entry section, and the second one is the exit section. In the entry section, we have the acquire function. And in the exit section, we have the release function. Okay. So we have the acquire function and we have the release function. So you can see that the acquire function and the release function is the part of the exit section and acquire function is the part of the entry section. So here also, as you can see, this is acquire. We have to acquire the log with the acquire function. And after that, we have to release the log with the release function. So this is your entry section. And this is your exit section. Okay. So let's do some example related to this. Now assume that we have two processes. So you assume this as the algorithm for process one and process two. So let's say we have zero and one. So let's say process zero and process one. We'll apply the same algorithm for that. Okay. Let's assume that the available, which is a common variable, this available value is true at very beginning. Okay. True at very beginning. And in this critical section, there is no process. Okay. Now, let's say P0 want to go into the critical section. So what it will do? P will call the acquire function. What acquire function is? It says that if not available, means not true, means it will become false, means this condition is not satisfied, then we'll go to the available equal to false. So that true will become the false. True will become the false, right? And then P0 will get into the critical section. So P0 will get into the critical section. Then after doing its work in the critical section, P0 will call the release log. Okay. Release, what release will do is it will make available as true. So this available will become, and this will also be out from the critical section and calling the release log, and release log will make available as true. Next time, let's say P1 want to enter into this. So P1 will also do the same thing. It will see whether it will call the critical section, entry section. So acquire will be called while not available. So true, not true will become false. So because it will become false, it will go to the next line, available equal to false. It will make it false and be in the critical section. So it will make it false and be in the critical section. When critical section process will be finished, it will call the release log. So it will be removed from it. It will call the release log and release will make it true. So this will make it true, right? So this will happen in the mutex log. Now, let's assume that so what we are thinking is, we are thinking that this particular solution will give us the solution for the critical section solution. So in the critical section solution, we have seen that there should be three criteria. First is the mutual exclusion. Second is the progress. And the third is the bounded weight. These four things should be satisfied. These three things should be satisfied. First is the mutual exclusion. Mutual exclusion says that if some process is already there in the critical section, so other process will not allow to be in the critical section. So let's see that mutual exclusion preserve here, or mutual exclusion is there in this particular solution or not. Okay. So for that, let's start with the beginning. Let's say P0 want to go into the critical section. So when it want to go to the critical section, it will call the acquire. So previously it was true. Acquire function will be called. It is not true means it is false. So this condition not satisfy. It will go to the next line, which is available equal to false. So we'll write this available equal to false for P0. For P0. So P0 will come in. Okay. Now the second thing what we have to do is, let's say P0 is in the critical section. Now P1 want to enter into the critical section. So can we allow in the mutual exclusion? We do not allow. So let's say if the P1 want to go into the critical section, so P1 call the acquire function, and in the acquire function it is while not available. So what is available is false. False will become not false. It will become true. So while true means this will be in a loop. So P1 will be in a loop, and that loop is called busy wait. So it will wait for a time when the available will become true. So till now it has to wait here, means it will be in a loop. So we can say that if P0 is in the critical section, P1 is not allowed to be in the critical section. Why? Because we have made this available as false. So the availability of the critical section is false right now. So P0 cannot enter into critical section. So mutual exclusion is there. Now the second criteria is the progress. Progress is there or not. Progress means if some process want to go into the critical section, and if critical section is free, so it will be allowed to go into the critical section. Okay, so what I told that if critical section is free and some process want to go into the critical section, so we have to allow. So let's say if P0, let's say there is nothing and P1 want to go into the critical section, can we allow it? So here you can see this particular solution is allowing it. But there is a scenario where it cannot allow. Like let's say P0 has entered into the critical section by acquiring it. So it will become false. The true will become false. Okay. And P0 will be here. Now, when after the critical section work is finished, P0 has to release from here. P0 has to release from here. So after releasing, let's say, and before calling the release function, let's say the context which happened means, let's say the preemption happened. So P0 is not there, but the release function has not been executed by P0. And let's say P1 want to enter into the critical section. Even though critical section is free, but available is false, right? Available is false. Why? Because P0 has not, here there is a preemption, and P0 has not done its execution. So in that particular case, you can see that the progress will not be allowed. Means P0 want to go into the critical section, even though critical section is free, that is not at all allowed. Okay. Not allowed to go into the critical section. But in some book, that is not at all the assumption. The assumption is, whenever we leave the critical section, we leave the critical section after release function will be executed. So you are in the critical section, you be in the critical section till you call this particular function. So you are in the critical section, you want to go out from the critical section, so you have to call this particular function, then only you can be released from the critical section. So in that particular case, progress will be there. So if there is a process, if there is a process, it always be false. And if there is no process, it means that it should be true. Then only that process will be released from here. So in that case, the progress is there. In that case, the progress is there. Now, let's go for the third condition, which is called bounded wait. Bounded wait means if some process is acquiring the critical section again and again, and if a new process came, let's say it want to go to the critical section, so the willingness should be known. But for the willingness, there is no variable, or there is no such facility which can store the willingness of a process. So if we cannot store the willingness of a process, so definitely there is no way we can find it out if some process want to go into the critical section and will make the decision. So in that case, the mutex lock is not at all fulfilling the requirement of bounded wait. So a process is going to wait for a longer period of time. Whenever there is a release from the critical section, this bounded wait will be, or this loop will be over and will become, that process will make it false and will go to the critical section. Okay, that is a possibility, but we doesn't have the willingness where we can store. If somebody want to go into the critical section, so that willingness to store, that facility is not there. But as soon as a process release the critical section, other process who want to go into the critical section can be in the critical section.